surprise, more bloodshed in the Middle East. This time an attack by an Israeli warplane results in the death of one of Israel's most wanted, Hamas leader Saleh Shehadeh, described by Israel as the Gaza Strip's most brilliant and brutal terrorist. We're going to hear the Israeli point of view in just a moment, but first, reaction to yesterday's bombing from Hussein Ibish. She's the communications director for the Arab American Anti-Discrimination Committee. Hussein, thanks for joining us again.
It's always a pleasure.
Can't be a surprise that they would go after someone like this.
No.
Is it simply the death of this man that has you outraged or something?
No, it's really not. It's not so much the death of Saleh Shehadeh, who I'm not going to cry for, although I'm opposed to assassinations and extrajudicial executions, which are criminal. But it's more important that what the Israelis did was, in trying to assassinate him, they fired a missile from an F-16 into a residential apartment complex, killing 14 people and destroying 5 houses. 9 of those people at least were children, including 2 infants. So this is not simply an assassination. This is, by any definition, a war crime, a crime, and in fact, by any reasonable definition of the term, an act of terrorism as well.
Okay, well, when the United States went in with bombs and headed down tunnels or in
sure.
Afghanistan or went into areas to go after the bad guys, Al-Qaeda, and other people were affected, should we be tried as war criminals?
No, of course not, because we are not talking about assassinating individuals by bombing their apartment buildings and by blowing up them and all their neighbors. I think the White House got it right today when it said that analogy is completely bogus, and I'm offended by it. As a U.S. citizen, as an American, I'm very offended to hear the Israelis and their apologists trying to compare what they did in Gaza yesterday, this incredibly brutal act, to what the United States has done in regions like Tora Bora and rural Afghanistan.
Okay,
the White House is right.
What is the response when they say, look, five teens were killed by this man,
right.
he led the way many, many,
right.
many times, we're sorry civilians died, but...
Well, I mean, I think that's no excuse for doing the same kind of thing. I mean, the logic that you'll hear from the Hamas group is it's okay to kill Israelis because we have to liberate ourselves from occupation. And the logic you hear from Israelis is, hey, we're resisting terrorism, therefore we can blow up Palestinians willy-nilly, and it doesn't matter who gets in the way. The point is, both General Sharon, Ariel Sharon, and Hamas are killing people wantonly in the name of a military yeah. victory that will never come, and they're actually partners in promoting war mm. over negotiation. And every time we make a move towards peace, as we've been seeing in the past couple days, little bit of progress, one or the other, does something horrendous
okay.
to get us back on the war track.
All right, Hussein Ibish, not enough time, as always. Thank you very much.
It's
joining me for a different view.